Sage reporting for Kalkine Media here. Thanks for joining us. Today you are watching Kalkine Media's mid-market show, Price Sensitive Updates. In the ASX 200 today, the index was down nearly 0.9% in the afternoon. Australian stocks opened lower as the benchmark index nosedived at the beginning opening bell. Australian bond yields edged higher on Thursday. Incoming economic data this week showed economic recovery in the December quarter. On the commodity side, gold prices turned marginally higher in the afternoon and the financial sector was higher amid selling pressures. The real estate sector was also slightly higher in the afternoon, but the healthcare sector was down nearly 3%. Here are the latest price-sensitive updates from the ASX-listed companies. Shares of Myer Holdings Limited fell as much as 12.1% to A$0.290 today. The department store operator reported a first half sales drop of 13% to A$1.40 billion due to COVID-19 induced store closures. Its stock price is up 13.8% year to date as of last close. During mid-market trading session, Myer Holdings Limited's share price was down 9.091%. at A$0.30. Today, Xero Limited has announced the acquisition of Planday for $284.5 million. The company would pay upfront consideration in cash and shares. Planday is a workforce management platform having users in a UK and Europe. Xero Limited share price at noon was down 2.83% at A$115.63. Synliat Milk Limited today announced the withdrawal of its financial year 2021 guidance due to uncertain business conditions. The company noted that the demand from the A2 Milk Company remains uncertain for the rest of financial year 2021 and financial year 2022. Besides, the supply chain's delays would also impact the financial year 2021 results. Synliat Milk Limited share price was down 9.75% at A$3.24 today by lunchtime. Shares of construction and mining services provider Westar Industrial Limited gained as much as 23.5% to A$0.021. Its engineering contractor business, Simpec, received a $15 million new contract for Stage 1 improvement works for Pilgangoora Operations Pty, a unit of ASX-listed Pilbara Minerals. Simpec will execute the work and its joint venture partner Iron Merge. At noon, its share price was up 17.65% at A$0.020. QBE Insurance on Wednesday announced appointing Andrew Horton, CEO of UK-based specialist insurer Beazley, as its top boss. According to Reuters, Morgan Stanley remarked on the announcement that new QBE Insurance Chief Executive Andrew Horton's background as an external appointment with experience in the Lloyd's and UK market will not surprise investors. QBE's previous CEO Patrick Regan left in September last year after a probe found he fell short of the insurer's ethics and conduct standards. By lunchtime, QBE Insurance share price was up 2.801% at A$9.54. Salt Lake Potash Limited share price rose as much as 4.5% to A$0.465. The Potash Explorer reported a successful syndication of its $138 million senior debt facility with Sequoia Economic Infrastructure Income Fund, or SEQI, and Commonwealth Bank of Australia, joining the loan facility. Salt Lake Potash said that SEQI will invest $39 million and CBA will invest $25 million into the facility. By midday session, Salt Lake Potash share price was up 2.25% at A$0.455. Shares of Core Lithium jumped as much as 6.8% to A$0.235 today. The Lithium Explorer entered into an option to to acquire six mineral leases adjacent to its Finniss Lithium project, Northern Territory. The acquisition will support its future lithium production and downstream processing. At noon, core lithium share price rose 1.14% at A$0.222. Today, ECS Botanics shares rose as much as 8.1% to $0.067 Australian. The hemp-based food maker said that its recently acquired company, Murray Meds, has entered into a three-year contract to supply medicinal cannabis, dried flower and medicinal cannabis concentrate to an Australian cannabinoid company. The minimum spend across life of agreement is $750,000 with a forecast spend of $500,000 in first year. ECS Botanics share price was up 3.22% at A$0.064. Well, that's all for now. Keep watching Kalkine Media's mid-market show price sensitive updates for the latest news. Thank you for watching.